Hi, this is Dave Holmes from Chichester Music Academy, and today I'm going to teach you how to play the song Blurred Lines. Now, there's no guitar in the original recording, so I'm going to base this lesson on the cover by Duke, which you can find on YouTube, so check that out if you don't know it already. Good news is there's only two chords, G and D, but the bad news is they have to be bar chords. You're never going to get that funky rhythm sound if you've got open strings ringing. So, let's have a look at the G chord. The first bar chord that most of us learn is F, which you play down here on the first fret. So take your F chord and just slide it up two frets, and that becomes G. So that's the first one done. The second chord is D, and we're going to play that at the fifth fret. Now this is an A shape. It's based on this A chord that most of us know. And if you were to play that chord at the fifth fret with a bar, it would look like that, and that would be a D chord. But that's not a very practical way of playing that voicing. So I'm gonna play it like this. It's pretty much all the same notes. But what I'm doing is a partial bar with my third finger. So my third finger is pushing down the fourth string at the seventh fret, the third string, and the second string. And then my finger is sort of bent back a little bit so that I'm muting the first string. You don't want to fret that first string. If you do, you get this, which makes the chord a D6 chord, which is a very nice chord, but it's not the chord we need for this tune. So you just need to bend that knuckle back a little bit to mute that first string. And then my first finger comes down on the fifth fret of the fifth string to play the root note of D. Just look at the first finger for a minute. It might look like I'm doing a bar there, but I'm not. All I'm doing is pressing down the fifth string. And then all the strings underneath, the 4th, 3rd, 2nd and 1st strings, are muted. And I'm also muting the 6th string with the tip of my finger. So, if I were to play all 6 strings, the only string you would hear would be the 5th string. Okay? So it's good practice just to check that you've got your first finger in the right position when you play this voicing, before you put your third finger down. So it takes a bit of practice, this one, so be patient, but it's a very useful chord voicing, and it's really the only chord voicing that will allow us to play the rhythm. So let's have a look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So you want a nice relaxed right arm and right wrist, and that will give us the rhythm. The other thing to notice is that what I'm doing with my left hand, I'm playing the chord, and as soon as I do, I relax my grip with my left hand. I'm not taking my fingers off the strings, I'm just relaxing my grip, so my fingers are still in place. And this again is a very useful technique. Okay, so we've got our chord voicings, G and D. We know about the rhythm, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. And we know about releasing our grip when we play these chords with our left hand, which gives us that staccato, that funky sort of staccato sound. One more thing that you need to look at to play this song, as Duke have done, which is sliding into the chords. So at the beginning of each line, it's probably every 4 bars, you'll slide into the chord. So it sounds like this, 1, 2, 3, 4. So what I'm doing, I'm actually starting with that F shape at the second fret, which makes it an F sharp. 3, 4, and sliding the whole voicing up, which is not as easy as it might sound, as I've just proved. There you go, that's a better one. So again, this is something that if you're not used to it, might take a little bit of practice, so be patient and keep trying it. And I've just remembered one more thing about this tune that I wanted to point out. When they do the sing the blurred lines line, the guitarist adds a seventh to that D chord, which you can do with your little finger on the first string at the 8th fret. So there's a nice little variation which you can do if you want to. But those are all the key points of this tune. So practice your bar chords and have fun.